Hello everyone. So today's topic is heterogeneous migration of on-premise Oracle database. Here we are using EC2 as an Oracle on-premise Oracle database. EC2 will be the server to AWS RDS MySQL. And for this, we'll be using AWS SCT. So to carry on with the migration, we need to know the basics of SCT, which is Schema Conversion Tool, which I already discussed a bit on my DMS video. So this, what does the schema conversion tool does? It converts your existing schema from one database engine to another. You can convert relational OLTP schema or data warehouse schema, and your converted schema is suitable for an Amazon RDS. The converted schema can also be used with a database on an Amazon EC2 or stored as a data on an S3 bucket. So what is Amazon SCT? It provides a project-based user interface to automatically convert the database schema of your source database into a format compatible with your target Amazon RDS instance. If schema from your source database cannot be converted automatically, AWS SCT provides guidance on how you can create equivalent schema in your target Amazon RDS database. Let us move on and see how we can download, from where we can download our AWS SCT software. So this is the below link. If you need this link, please do let me know. I will send you the link through comments. So while clicking on the link, it will route to this page. And here you can also get the documentation on how you can install your AWS SCT. Also, you will be getting various versions of your AWS SCT in here. This you can get it for your Windows. You can, if you are using Mac OS, you need to download this. If you are using Ubuntu Linux or Fedora Linux, likewise, you need to take this. Now, for me, this is a Windows system. So for Windows system, I need to click on this link. And once you click, this will start downloading and the size is 839 MB. I have already downloaded it. Along with this, we also need the basic drivers versions for our SCT. So if you scroll in the link, through this link, you can see the fourth step, install the Java JDBC drivers for your source and target database engines. So once you click in here, you will get the links in here. For me, it is, I'm using Oracle as my source and MySQL as a target. So for target, you need to take this and you need to get the driver this or the updated driver also. So in here, the versions are not updated. It is just an explanatory version given in here. So for Oracle also, you need to check the versions and download it from the provided link. You need to remember one more thing in here is that AWS SCT is supported only in 64-bit version OS. So once your download is completed, what you need to do? You need to unpack it, and after unpacking it, unzipping it, you will get this. First and foremost thing, although this is you have downloaded from your Amazon website itself, so there should not be any problem with it, but still, if you want to verify whether this is authenticated one, you need to click on the properties of this MSI, and from here you need to go to the digital signatures and see the name of the signature. So this is Amazon Services LLC, name of the signer is present in here. So this is verified. Right now, what you need to do is you need to install your SCT. So next, I accept the terms in the license agreement. This will be installed in this location. And I'm installing it. I'll pause the video until this gets installed. So I'm done with the installation of AWS SCT tool. Let us log in. So right now I have opened the tool and it is opening. So this is opened, and you can set the location of the drivers locally in your settings. Or if you do not set the location of the drivers globally, the application asks you for the location of the drivers whenever you connect to a database. So let me set globally the connections. From the global settings, go to drivers. You need to browse from here, and from here you need to give the path. For my Oracle, it is ojdbc8.jar file, and for my MySQL driver path, it is from drivers. I have taken this jar file. So like this, you need to set the global path in here and click OK once you are done with it. Now you need to set the AWS credential with which your SCT, Amazon AWS SCT, will be logged into your AWS console. So from service provider, you need to give the name in here. For me, the name is Infra, and the AWS access key and secret key, those you need to give. For me, the access key is this. Don't worry, I will be deleting all these things once I am done with my video. And this is my secret access key. I do not need this. S3, you need to specify a bucket only if you are using a feature that connects to your S3. Right now, I do not need it. And for me, the region is Mumbai. So I will apply it. You can test the connection also from here. This is testing the connections. So you can see in here that it has passed all of the tests, required tests. No? Okay. So this is done. The Oracle user must have these privileges before you can connect to your SCT. Means for your SCT conversion, you need these privileges given to your Oracle user. So please take this in mind if you are migrating, if you are doing a heterogeneous migration. Now, let me create a project where my source database from my from as you can see in here, from file I get into new project. You can change this project name and location where you want to give. As per your project work, you need to give this one as transactional database, OLTP or OLAP or NoSQL database. For me, my source engine is Oracle. If it is something else for you, you can put it in here. For the target engine is Amazon RDS. For MySQL, you can see from here what all target engines are there. Okay. Now let's connect to the Oracle. The server name is given, and this is the DMA user which I will be using. Let me give the password for this. Store the password and test the connection. So my connection is successful for my Oracle database. And it is loading the metadata in here. You can see from here, connect to Amazon RDS for MySQL. Here you need to give the RDS name. So let me log into my RDS. This is the endpoint, RDS endpoint, which we need. The server port is by default 3306, and my user is Infra itself. One more thing you need to remember in here is that the publicly accessibility should be yes, or else your SCT won't be able to connect with the RDS database. Let me give the password in here and test the connection. So my connection is successful. So this is done. Now this is a tree. This is for my source database and this is for my target database. From here, if you go to global settings and tree view, from here you need to select your database Oracle. From here, hide empty schemas and uncheck all. If you do this, you can see in here all the schemas have been replicated, but I do not need these system schemas to be present. So I'm applying this, my system schemas have gone. You can see that one schema is there, three schemas are there right now, DMA, public and testing. I need to hide my empty schemas also. I'll apply this. You can see that the testing schema, which was an empty schema, that is also gone. That is a basic global level of filtering out. And if you filter it out from here, you can click on this link and from here you can give the schema name and apply. See, my public schema has gone. Now from here you can see the tables and all which are there right now. Just think, if you have done this today and you need to migrate tomorrow, so there might be some changes, there might be some new tables, there might be some new objects, so you need to refresh it. How you can do it? You can go in here, refresh from database. If you click this option, your new tables or new objects, everything will be refreshed. So this is done. Now what I need to do for my this schema, I need to create the DMS assessment report. So what is DMS assessment report? The database migration assessment report summarizes all of the action items for schema that cannot be converted automatically to the engine of your target Amazon RDS DB instance. This report also includes estimates of the amount of effort that it will take to write the equivalent code for your target DB instance. In my case, this being a demo environment, it will pass for all of the values. So as I said, it will be passing all the values, and for your project environment, this might fail, where you need to troubleshoot along with your developers. This is just a demo version to show how you can perform your heterogeneous migration. So you can see of all the total five database storage objects in the source database, we identified 500% database storage objects that can be converted to Amazon RDS for MySQL automatically or with minimal changes. So if you want, you can save this to PDF if you need. And from the graph also, you can see this green shows that objects automatically converted. And this light green means with simple actions needs to be taken for those to be converted, for those to convert. For me, this is not needed at all, since this is a totally demo environment. And here you can see objects with a medium complexity actions and objects with complex actions. Likewise, you need to select and you need to proceed. So I do not need this too. If you want, you can save it from here, save to PDF. Now I need to convert my schema. So how do we do it? Go to here. This is the target you can see. From here, there are four schemas present in here and there's nothing with the name of DMA present in here. So how do I do it? You need to convert this schema. These objects might already exist in the target database. Replace if it's already there. You can see that these have come to your DMA. Now let me log into my RDS database and see whether this has already come or not. Show databases is a command. Well, this has not come. Why this has not come? This is still in my local data, local desktop itself. I need to upload it. How do I do this? Apply to database. You chose to apply the schema definition for DMA. Are you sure? Yes, I'm sure. Now I'm applying this to my database. One more thing you need to see that this table, let me see. Let me log into my Oracle database. And see the count. So this has, this table has this many counts and WLS log has these many counts. So in here you can see that this is already done. Let me check from my database. Show databases, let me see if previously it was not there. So you can see in here that the database has come. You need to remember one thing, that the schemas, this is represented as schemas in Oracle, and for MySQL this is represented as database, and this whole is represented as the instance. So this is a database. Let me log into this database. So currently I am in my DMA user. Let me see what all tables are present in here. We do have, so these two tables have been applied to the database, but do we really have anything present in this? The count will be zero. For the other table, the count is also zero. So why did this did not come? This is because we just converted our schema and its objects to the MySQL database from Oracle database, but we did not migrate any data. Right now what we need to do is we need to migrate the data, and for this we need to log into our AWS console, and from there we need to go to our DMS. So let us log into our AWS console and go to DMS service. In DMS service, let me create the replication instance as heterogeneous, description as Oracle to MySQL, engine version let it be the same, then VPC I'll just the default VPC, and I'll just create it. While this is creating, you can see from here, from the main view, the properties created when object name this, related converted objects will be shown in here, mapping, object type, schemas.dma, target schemas.dma, from the properties the object name and the apply status you can see here successful. So my this schema has two tables, DMA123, WLSLog, both have been successfully applied to my RDS database. Right now, I'll pause the video until this EC replication instance gets created. So my replication instance has been created. Right now, let me create the endpoints. The source endpoint, let me give the name as Oracle. Engine as Oracle. The server name, let me copy the server name. This is my instance. This is my server name. The port is 1521 for Oracle. The user is DMA. I'm giving the password. SID is proddb, the same which I used while we were migrating our on. While I showed the migration of my full load and full load plus CDC. I will run the test and let me see whether the test is successful or not. Basically, all the steps will be same as if you have seen my videos on migration of full load and full load CDC from on-premise Oracle to AWS RDS Oracle. So my source endpoint has been tested successfully. Let me create the target endpoint. The target endpoint select from the RDS DB instance. It will be taking everything automatically. Let me give the just the password and test the connection once more. So my test is successful. Connection test is successful. I will create the target endpoint also. Now, let me go ahead and create the task. My task would be to MySQL migration. My replication instance, my source instance, my target database, and I will go ahead with the migrate existing data, target table preparation, do nothing. Enable validation, enable CloudWatch logs if you need, the target data load this if you need. Selection rules, enter the schema with this name, and the transformation rules, schema, DMA, and rename to DMA value, and I will set up this task. I'll create this task. So my task is creating and the status is right now creating. I will pause the video until this runs. Right now my task is running and you can also check the logs from your CloudWatch logs. You can see from here what all things are happening in your migration. So right now you can see that my load also completed. So my task is complete right now. Let me log into my schema and see whether this has completed or not. You can see from here that the previous count was 00. Let me use the database and select count star. You can see that the count was 6 for DMA123, which has been migrated, and for this also, which was 3 for WLS log, this also has been migrated. Also, you can see that from if you go to your SCT tool, from there, if you go to view and database migration view, you can see that the ID Oracle to MySQL, which was my task name, this got created and the status of it is load complete with the type as full load. So you can check from here what all tables have been loaded, what all tables are queued, and what all tables errored out, and the elapsed time to do this. For me, since there was not no load and no data also, that's why it completed. So that is all about today's session on migrating an Oracle on-premise database to AWS RDS MySQL, which is a heterogeneous migration where we are using AWS SCT. If you like my video, please do share, subscribe, and comment. Thanks a lot for watching the video. Take care.